I would like to thank the Pennsylvania Psychological Association for inviting me here today to address my safe harbor bill and the driving intent behind the legislation. You may know that I've been fighting for years for statute of limitations reform for victims of childhood sex abuse. Through this work, and as a victim of childhood sex abuse, I know the devastation that these unspeakable crimes inflict on children and their unsuspecting families. Even within a supportive community framework, it takes victims on average decades to come forward and seek justice for the grave harm they endured in silence. Now, imagine the child who ran away, or was kidnapped, or is undocumented, or was promised fame and fortune, only to be scooped up by an abuser, a pimp, or a seasoned trafficker. Like all child predators, these exploiters are master manipulators. They know exactly how to psychologically and physically control their young victims. Victims of human trafficking are forced into a world of prostitution, drugs, and all sorts of illegal activity. They are raped, beaten into submission. Their IDs are confiscated. Many are tattooed. They come to rely on their masters for their very existence. Human trafficking is nothing short of modern-day slavery. And let me say that again. Human trafficking is nothing short of modern-day slavery. Children are especially vulnerable, as they never had the chance to develop skills to identify, avoid, and resist adults who pose as friends. We must stop treating these children who find themselves in the most deplorable of situations as criminals. They are victims. Instead of facing criminal charges, we need to work with our law enforcement community to identify sexually exploited kids and get them to a safe setting, not jail. They deserve immunity, not re-victimization. We need to provide them services that will help rehabilitate, educate, and get them on the path to being a productive member of our society. And much progress was made in 2014 with Act 105, which extensively revised our laws on human trafficking. But when it comes to children who are sexually exploited, we need to do much more. We need to provide them a safe harbor. In order to do this, my legislation calls on the Department of Human Services, in collaboration with every county agency and child welfare service, to develop a statewide protocol to get these kids the help they need to move on. And believe me, I know that this is a tall order for an already grossly burdened system, but last year, 151 cases of human trafficking within our Commonwealth were reported to the National Human Trafficking Hotline. I'm betting, and I'm sure you are out here as well, that that number was greatly underreported, and that most victims started out as children. Now, the good news is that Senator Greenleaf's bill concerning human trafficking of children recently passed the Senate. I support the Senator's bill. However, I will expand the provision on immunity from prosecution with an amendment when it comes to the House floor for a vote. These children deserve a clean slate. While we debate policy, budgets, and questions of law, the children in this Commonwealth continue to suffer. We must right these wrongs now and go after the real criminals, the pimps, the perpetrators, and the exploiters of our kids. I also want to take a moment here to acknowledge I have some guests from Barrio Alegre Dance Company and the Reading Public Library. Together they developed a community project which deals with the issue of human trafficking. Please stay around after the press conference to see a brief preview of their interpreted dance. And again, I want to thank the Pennsylvania Psychological Association for allowing me to be part of this press conference today. Because I don't want just the people in the 126th District to know that I stand up and fight for kids. I want the people around this Commonwealth to know that I will stand up and fight for the kids of this Commonwealth no matter what. Thank you.